Hey everybody, it's Jess here at Village Green, and what we're going to talk to you about today is proper watering for your plants. Now, I have been in this industry and working here at Village Green for more than half of my life, and one of the biggest issues that we see is improper watering. So, what better way to do it than to show you how we do it here? So, basically, gardening has sort of changed over the last several years. A lot of people still do their own container gardens like this one here on the end. But a lot of people now come to the garden center, they buy pre-made things. We have pre-made hanging baskets, we have pre-made container gardens, and you literally just maybe take the hangers off of these and set them on the patio stoop and you call it done. But what we need to do is we need to educate you guys on how to properly water and care for these plants. So the biggest thing that you need to start with is fertilizer. So we are super excited right now that we are selling you the same fertilizer that we use here at Village Green. So if you want to grow like a pro, pick up the Jax fertilizer. We have a special petunia feed, which are great for mixed containers like this, or we have just a standard all-purpose. So plants are like people, and you have to feed them in order for them to grow and thrive. So be sure to fertilize at least once a week. Okay? If you're not going to fertilize, you're not going to see great success with your plant. So be sure to check out the Jax fertilizer and grow like a pro. Now, what you do not want to do when watering is you do not want to do one of these jobs, okay? You want to get your watering wand down in there like this. You want to fill up that container with water. So we're giving things good drinks. The best and easiest way to water is with a garden hose, and you want to get a long watering wand like this, which of course we sell here at Village Green, but you see that gives you nice watering pressure. Watering cans are okay if you have to use them, although I have to be honest with you, I loathe watering cans. I just do not think you get the best use of watering your plant when you do it that way. So when you're watering your hanging basket, you're gonna wanna put your watering wand down there and hold it for at least 3 to 5 seconds so that that container gets full of water. Now I bet you, if I lift this up, the water eventually is gonna start leaking out of the bottom. That's not a bad thing, that's a very good thing. You want the water to run through your pot. So many times people think, you know, I'm gonna water my plant maybe once a week or once every, you know, 3 or 4 days. The warmer it gets, the more you need to water. I would recommend that you water your plants if they're out in full sun, that you water them once every other day, and you want to water them like this so you make sure that they're getting enough water. So here I've got a geranium basket, a larger geranium basket. So I'm going to let that watering wand sit in there for about 4 to 5 seconds. Again, making sure that this plant's getting a nice drink. Now, this plant on the end here, I have a hibiscus bush. Now, this could be, you know, comparable to maybe a tree or shrub. So one of the biggest things that people do is while they're waiting to plant their plants, they're not watering these containers properly. When this plant comes into us and we start watering them here at the store, the water runs through this so quickly. So sometimes you have to water these twice. So I'm going to water this. The water's already starting to run out the bottom. I'm going to let the plant soak up all of that water until I can see the soil again. And I'm going to water it one more time, making sure that this plant is getting enough water. Now, when you plant new trees, new bushes, new shrubs, you want to make sure that you're watering those things on the regular until that plant is established. If you do not do that and you think, oh, I have a sprinkler system or I watered it once or twice, that plant will probably die. So by making sure that you're going out there for at least the first couple of months and watering that thing every other day is going to ensure that your plant is going to have a better survival rate. So let's make sure that you get out there, that you water those plants properly, especially the warmer that it gets, and that you're feeding them with fertilizer. We hope to see you soon at Village Green.